Greetings, it's New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher, the formulator of the Candida range of products. Thank you to all my subscribers for continuing to give me lots of different kinds of questions. I've got a question here from a man in Holland, in a place called Groningen in Holland, Paul Wies. And Paul's asking me if there's a connection between mast cell activity or disease and yeast infection. So mast cells are specific kinds of white blood cells. They were discovered in the 1870s by a researcher, and basically what he found when he stained them, stained a slide of blood, a blue colour, he found that these things were sort of had all little, you know, dark blue patches in them. And what he discovered is these were basically little white cells that were stuffed full of things, like little bags inside a bag. And these bags, interestingly, secrete chemicals in their own right, particularly a chemical called histamine. So histamine is a chemical that can induce quite a lot of different reactions in the body, especially allergic kinds of reactions. So you may have heard of the word antihistamine. Antihistamines are prescribed by doctors generally with an allergic response. So if you've had a bee sting, or if you suffer from, you know, sinus problems, sneezing, seasonal allergies, you know, things like that, you'll be given an antihistamine. And that reduces swelling, burning, stinging, itching, sneezing, you know, those typical kinds of reactions. So when a mast cell releases histamine, it will do so in a response to something around that irritates it or that triggers it. Mast cells typically line areas of the breathing passage of the body. They line around the eyes, around the nose, deep inside the head and the ears, the throat, the genital region, the digestive tract. You know, the skin, many areas actually contain mast cells. I've read an interesting article here, pretty heavy going, on the internet, role and relevance of mast cells in fungal infections. So this is a 38-page article along with quite a few references. I think it's got about 138 references, so it's a good science paper. And the paper is really all about bacteria and parasites. And there's also a big section in the back there on fungal infections, how they stimulate mast cells. Interesting there, the researchers found in the digestive system that the release of histamine increases digestive permeability, i.e. leaky gut. So, you know, this is quite a well-written paper where they're now actually saying that Candida creates leaky gut. There's certainly a link between mast cell activity and yeast infection. So Candida releases chemicals which upregulate the mast cell response. The mast cell will release histamine, which will see this as a foreign chemical, and in turn, the chemicals, when histamines are secreted, it in turn will start upregulating the immune system. So basically, it's like somebody ringing up the police, and then the police find out something bad's going on, and they in turn could call the armed defender squad. So, you know, that's what's basically happening here. The police being the histamine response, and then the histamines in turn calling on higher authorities to deal with these, you know, strong kind of reactions. And some of these armed defenders can get a bit trigger happy, if you know what I mean. You know, I was talking to an interesting patient the other day in America, a black lady who got pulled over for a very minor infringement, and before she knew it, she was at the police station getting knocked around just for a flat tire. I was quite surprised to hear of such racial prejudice. And the overstrong reaction by the police, the white Caucasian police, how they handled this incident involving a black person. I was quite disgusted to hear that. And, you know, you can't blame the police. I mean, there's no blame here. But what I'm saying is it was an overreaction, a very powerful overreaction. Now, that's what happens with histamine. It's an overpowering reaction to the body's response. Now, in some cases, a histamine response can kill people. Some people can be so sensitive to bee venom that a bee sting can kill them. More people in Australia, I've read, die from bee stings than from snake bites and other, you know, toxic animals that they have there. And that's because people swim in pools and they'll get a bee in the mouth and it'll sting them in the throat, which is full of mast cells. And, of course, huge amount of histamine gets secreted. And these are just people like you and I, perhaps, who just react normally to a bee sting. And of course, this bee venom in the throat closes off the airway and the person dies. Very strong overproduction of chemical inflammatory mediators with weird names like interleukin and tumor necrosis factor alpha. There are many different interleukins. You've got, you know, 4, 8, 6, 12. I mean, I think there's like dozens of interleukins. And each one of these specific chemicals has its own particular type of inflammatory reaction on the body. It in turn escalate another kind of reaction with names as long as, you know, as your auntie that you can't even pronounce. So I don't want to go into all that biochemistry. So the point is that candida can create the release of histamine from the mast cell. Histamine in turn upregulates other responses, and so it goes. So don't forget that there's a powerful relationship with histamine in the gut and leaky gut. And there's also a very strong relationship with yeast infection and food allergies. So now you can start seeing where that link is, with the leakiness of the gut being stimulated by histamine and its chemical mediators. And then, of course, the gut becomes more permeable. And then when that permeability happens, proteins can leak through and affect the immune system on the other side, creating allergic responses. So what we can gain from this is that when we clean up the gut, get rid of this overproduction of candida, bring the balance back, get the beneficial bacteria again, reduce the production of histamine, we're going to get a decrease in the leaky gut and an improvement in the allergies, which proves what I've always said to people. Most people are not allergic to gluten. They just have to basically clean up their gut, and then they can eat a wide range of foods again. So, Paul, to answer your question, is there a link between mast cell activity and candida? There certainly is. Thanks for tuning in.